Hello everyone, welcome back to Peter Chen Design Channel. Let's talk about the very interesting commands called Tween Curve and how to create this very interesting organic form. Let's get started. Let's start with the front view. We are going to draw two lines here. And I'm going to turn on my grid snap. I'm going to do a line approximately going like this up and down. Okay, and the other line I'm going to do is in the opposite direction. I will go down first and I will go into the top, right? So a kind of pointed figure eight shape there. So with those two lines, I'm going to make a little bit distance to separate them in between. Alright, now if we want to create a surface, we could just loft it. And what we are going to do is going to the loft command, and you have from here to here. And then you get this really straightforward surface right there. I'm just going to put it there for the comparison. The command we are going to use is called Tween Curve. So you type it T-W-E-E-N. Tween Curve will show. And then I'm going to start, this is start, this is end, and you will see the line there. Now on the command bar, you ask you like how many pieces do you want in between. So right here I have 8. We can do it more or less, and I'm just going to keep it 8. So then it will automatically generate this curve from that to that, even it out for 8 of them. Okay, so why might I need to have this as a comparison? If I'm going to do loft again, and then I'm going to turn, make sure my record history is on, and I'm going to select all those curves over there, and I'm going to loft it. Alright, and then what is different than the first one there? You can see the curve we have, instead of straight going down, it has a little bit curvature right there. And since we turn on the history and we have this curve in the middle, so for example, I can turn on the control point and I can keep editing and my history will follow. Okay, so it's a good thing to have the history on, as you can always see the change in life. But this is not what we are looking for there, so I'm going to go back one more step here. Okay, we have all those curves. I'm going to select all of them, and I'm going to extrude it into the surface first. So let's go into the surface, extrude the curve straight. Make sure we want only one side, we don't need both sides. And I want them to just touching each on the next one. So that's how we get this surface right there. Let's go to the surface and we have offset surface. Let's do one first and see how it goes. We're gonna pick up this one and then you can set up the distance. I have a distance here for one and you can flip the direction if you like it going to the other side. So that's how you get the distance. Now let's do all of them at once. Their direction going to the same way, so I'm just gonna click OK. Then I will get this very fluid, interesting form there. And I'm gonna move this on the side for the comparison. Let's go to the top view, and we are going to create two closed curves. They are pretty organic. It's going to be like this, and the other one, it's possible it's going to look like this, for example. And that's going to use the align tool and align to the center, align to the zero. Okay, so in the perspective view, we're going to move one of it up to whatever desired height over there. And we're gonna use the same command, Tween Curve. Pick up the start and the end. And then you are going to see something like this. You can kind of moving the point or click on those points and for them to align better in the way that you like. You can kind of play around it. So once you have that, we can do the same thing. But this time, since this is a closed curve, we're going to turn it into the solid directly. That's going to the solid, and that's kind of moving up a little bit. It's more like in the building, then you have a different floor. You can do the same thing like this. Okay, so one more thing that I wanted to show you here. What if I make this shape and realize I want them to twist a little bit more? Okay, so we could use the twist command, but I want to show you the difference by twist it right now or twist before you extrude. So let's go to the twist command. That's snapping the axis to the zero. Moving to the front view, I'm going to hold my shift and click. Coming back to the top view, and I'm going to click on the top view and kind of twist maybe 180 degree right there. Okay, so now we see this shape, and I'm going to keep this one as a comparison. So let me go ahead to select the poly surface that we just did and deselect those. Let me move this on the side. Okay, so now we have one for the comparison. I find the original one before we twist. Then we want to go to the twist command before we turn it into the solid. So let's go to the twist. We're gonna snap it into the zero, the same like we did on the previous one. And we're holding the shift, click, go back to the top view, click, and click 180 degree. Okay, so notice that what I was twisting is the curve instead of the surface, and they are in the same angle right now. So let's go ahead to turn them into the solid, extrude the planar curve straight, and I would like to make them as close to the one that we had there. So let me turn off the old snap and something like this. Okay, the shape is twist, but in the way I'm twisting the curve, so I can maintain the wall is still straight. That this one, the wall is twist on the side. It's not really a preference, but if I'm going to 3D print and turn this one on the left to the mesh, it will make my model very complicated. But it really depends on what you're looking for. If you want to have the wall is straight but just the form twist, or the other way. Okay, I hope you enjoyed the video. Please subscribe it and don't forget to click that little bell next to it, so whenever I have new things coming up, you will get a notification from me. Thank you for watching. I'll see you next.